Hello and welcome to yet another neurophysiology video in which we are going to cover the mechanism of central hypotonia or development of persistent flaccidity in upper motor neuron lesions. Now, in our previous two videos on spasticity and rigidity, we have covered the two main subtypes of the upper motor neuron lesion. Namely, in the first variety, it was both the pyramidal and the extrapyramidal system getting damaged, leading to production of the spasticity. And in the type 2, it was the extrapyramidal system that was getting affected and which in turn was leading to development of rigidity. Now, sometimes in our clinical practice, we can come across such cases in which, although it is a case of upper motor neuron type, but still there is persistent hypotonia present in those patients. And even during our follow-ups after 3 months, 6 months or 1 year, we find out that there is still hypotonia present in such patients. So how can we explain the development of hypotonia or persistent hypotonia in a patient of UMN disorder? Let's try and understand. Now, this type of UMN disorder is the third variety in which there is pure pyramidal lesion. Now, that means that the extrapyramidal system is functioning properly, but there is problem only in the pyramidal tracts and the structures. So now let's see what is going to happen to the muscle stretch reflex in a patient who is going to develop pure pyramidal lesion. Now, in such a situation, the excitatory discharges to the reticular activating system will be completely lost from the cortex, and the inhibitory or the regulatory discharges to the reticular activating system are going to make the reticular activating system dormant. And because of this, there will be no or very little excitatory discharges that will be going down from the RS to the gamma motor neuron. And because of these weak discharges or practically no discharges, the gamma motor neuron activation to the muscle spindle will be lost. Now, what is going to happen if the muscle spindle is going to remain flaccid? In such a situation, it will become insensitive to any kind of stretch. And so, because there will be no recording of the stretch, therefore, no conduction is going to flow through the muscle stretch reflex arc, and thereby the muscle is going to become flaccid. So now, please keep in mind, because of over-inhibition of the reticular activating system, in conditions of pure pyramidal lesion, there is going to be lack of gamma motor neuron firing, and this is going to suppress the muscle stretch reflex activity, and thereby there is going to be persistent hypotonia or central hypotonia, what we call, and is seen in upper motor neuron lesion. So now, from now onwards, the student should take a note that flaccidity is not only seen in LMN lesions, it can also be seen in the upper motor neuron lesion only when it is a pure pyramidal variety. Please do keep motivating us with your comments and feedbacks. See you all in our next video. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing, and stay connected.